So I will start the assembly and perhaps make some notes in the video along the way. Well, as you can see, I didn't even stop and take any construction pictures. This is the finished key. From where you saw it when I left off the video, it's been about an hour. And that included doing some minimum polishing to the brass. The brass had a what's called a machine finish on it, which as it comes out of the machine shop. And I started with 150 grit, went to 200 grit sandpaper, 320 grit, 400 grit, 600, and I actually had just a sheet of 1400 sandpaper here, and I hit a lick or two on it. But that's the finished product that I have here. Works great. A couple of warnings, though, if you were to build this, the instructions clearly say to put all the small parts in a box. Well, I had them on this shop cloth here thinking that they would not roll around very much. Well, what happened when I went to pick something up, I inadvertently pinched the cloth in with one of those brass pieces, and I went to turn around, and when I did, parts flew everywhere all over the workshop. And it took a long time to find all of those things together. And the instructions again clearly say to put that in a small box with about a 1-inch lip on it. And please do that. You'll save yourself a lot of time. Now, the hour from a while ago does not count me on the floor of my shop hunting up those small parts. It's a pure assembly is what it is. Up close, you can see that it's just machine screws, some socket head screws. The contacts are silver plated, where you can see right in the middle of your screen is silver plated contacts on both of them. There was only one soldering joint. It's here on the bottom. Now, you can see in your screen, perhaps, right here. Let me see if I can get this thing down a little closer. Right here, you'll see that there are two very tiny silver wires. I think it's 32 gauge. And that's what carries the contact up to the two paddles. And those are soldered to a common ground right here. And then the dit and the dah paddle go on each side of it. Of course, it's got the little rubber feet to hold it in place. It's a rather a weighty key. It doesn't mean heavy by being weighty. I just mean for the size, it tends to stay in place very well. The only modification that I made, and it really wasn't a modification, it was an addition. And right here where my thumb is, this is where the audio cable comes in, the three-conductor audio cable. I took some shim stock, and shim stock is just something that it's exactly what it is. You shim things up at a machine shop with it. It's just very thin brass. You can also probably use this thing out of an aluminum can. And I just folded it over. Perhaps you can see right there. But I just made a little U-clamp to take and make a strain relief for the cable. So when it moves around on the desk, there'll be something to prevent it from prying apart the solder joints. So that's the Black Widow Mini Paddle. I'll crank this thing up and I'll show you how it works here. Over here is just a small MFJ keyer. It's a practice keyer, but it's also a keyer that goes into radio. I'll turn it on and swap hands just here. Try not to move the camera a great deal. Come around and we'll see how it sounds here. Turn it up a little bit here. Turn it up on the edge and see what it does. So we'll try it here. Speed up just slightly. Put it over here on a more solid place. All righty, let's try this. So that's the CQ call, as you know, and that it concludes the review on the Arizona Mini Paddle. Highly recommend it, really good feel to it. and I'm going to use this as part of my QRP package for sending CW. Hope to catch you on the airwaves. This is John, W5CYF 73.